While Turkey's Erdogan spouts hatred against Israel, one of the Jewish state's best friends is speaking out on her behalf. CBN's David Brody talked with U.S. Ambassador to the UN, Nikki Haley, on the sidelines of the Christians United for Israel conference in Washington.
When it comes to supporting Israel, you're going to be hard-pressed to find a bigger defender than Nikki Haley. Her passion was on display Monday evening in front of the influential evangelical group Christians United for Israel.
Let me tell you, it's a new day at the UN. From now on, every country knows that the United States will not just block anti-Israel measures, we will shine a light on those who are responsible. There won't be any more free passes for those who bully Israel at the UN.
Haley's time at the UN has been marked by a full-throttle defense of Israel. In an interview with CBN News, she expressed excitement to see that the hard work is beginning to pay off as skeptical UN members begin to see the anti-Israel terrorist group Hamas for what it is.
The idea that we could get the majority of the General Assembly for the first time to even acknowledge that Hamas is an issue was a fantastic win.
Haley also sees a winning team in the support evangelicals have shown Israel for decades.
When you look at the anti-Semitism, you look at all of the harassment that they're getting around the world, you do feel for them because you know these are good people trying to live a good life that are in a dangerous region. And I think that Christians United, they see that for what it is.
She's also calling out certain United Nations bodies and their questionable decisions.
The Human Rights Council is a farce.
She got the U.S. to pull out, calling it full of hypocrisy.
What we've said is you've got serious human rights abuses, whether it's in Venezuela, whether it's in Iran, where they're protesting their regime, whether it's in Nicaragua, and they're doing nothing about it.
The phrase doing nothing is not in Ambassador Haley's vocabulary.
Since day one, you've gone in there to shake things up. How tough has that been?
Every day I put on body armor because I know there's going to be a fight. I'm just fighting a different thing every day.
Often on that daily agenda, Iran, Russia, and dealing with North Korea.
Do you think they understand the message that what denuclearization means to the United States?
I think that North Korea understands the message, they just don't like to hear it. We're not going to loosen sanctions, we're not going to do congratulatory statements until we see actions to stand by their words that they're going to denuclearize. And I think they've got some soul searching to do.
On the Russia front, she's okay with President Trump talking to Vladimir Putin, even in private, despite some of the criticism.
He did that with Kim. He's done it with other leaders. He did it with President Xi of China, and that's just his way. He feels like he can get more out of them if he goes one-on-one like that. It's his style. It's the way he does it. You can't get to the end of the other side if you don't have those conversations.
Despite the appearance of friendly talking with Russia, she makes one thing perfectly clear.
We don't trust Russia. We don't trust Putin. We never will. They're never going to be our friend. That's just a fact.
Iran fits that category as well, especially after its president, Hassan Rouhani, warns Americans that a war with Iran would be the mother of all wars.
Iran has made or has received their legitimacy by rhetoric. It has the Europeans and everyone that was involved in the Iran deal scared of what they might do. We don't fall for that.
The world is indeed a dangerous place, and it has Nikki Haley keeping the faith.
We just have to keep doing our part, and we have to make sure that we're being true to ourselves, true to our values, true to what we believe in, and not compromise on that. And I have faith it's all going to work out in the end.
David Brody, CBN News, Washington. Alpha Omega.